Hi, this is Shreya from AsiaNet, and today we have been joined by the very lovely Sonia Rathi, who will be seen in Broken But Beautiful Season 3. Hi Sonia, how are you? How's the US?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. I'm doing good too. So it's lovely having you here, and we'll be beginning with a questionnaire. But before that, I would like to ask you that how was your whole lockdown situation with the pandemic hitting our lives, and how much did you miss? I know that you have been, you know, shooting for Broken But Beautiful while we were in the pandemic, but overall, how was the experience of, you know, being at home and getting locked in the house?
Well, last year when the pandemic hit, it was me, Ankur, and Anuja. Anuja, my future sister-in-law, and all three of us were locked in the house. And I think we stayed in India for about 4 months. And then that was interesting. A lot of growth. And we found different ways to keep ourselves busy. And then I traveled back. We all traveled back to our families. Hamari sari family in India and US mein rehti hai. So we all traveled back, and then I came back to shoot Broken, but yeah, it was pretty tough because, you know, even though we were shooting and we were working, a lot of our families were kind of affected, you know. Just because we were working doesn't mean that it was out of sight, out of mind. And even personally, my own parents and my brother got affected with COVID while I was shooting. So we kind of became like a family while we were shooting, and we got through it together. And then after that, the second wave hit, and yeah, that was pretty scary. So I stayed there for a bit, and then the borders were coming down. So I was like, I need to get to my family, and I came back.
The trailer shows you in a very powerful role. So I would like to ask you that, what drew you towards this character, and tell us more about it.
Yeah, of course. So what drew me towards Rumi in the beginning was actually her feistiness and her going after what she wants without any kind of inhibitions or anything like that, you know. And she's also a little relatable as well. She's a 20-something girl going through her life figuring it out, and I am also 20-something and I'm figuring it out. So it was relatable in that sense, and you know, the amount of emotions she has, gussa hai, frustration hai, pyar hai. We've all experienced even a little bit of that in our lives. So she had, it was an all-round kind of character, and I was really drawn to her from the beginning. Just by doing the audition, I loved it.
So what are the similarities that you find in Rumi and yourself in terms of the characteristics, in terms of the emotions and feelings that she feels very strongly about? So do you have any similarities? Do you establish any similarities with the character in your real life?
Sometimes I feel like the feistiness that Rumi has, I wish I had. So that's one. But similarities wise, I think it is physicality. We don't have anything in similar ways at all. But emotional, I think it is the fact that she is trying to figure out her life, you know, and I'm also doing the same. And understanding what you want. I don't. I mean, I know everybody is still trying to figure that out. So, yeah.
How was it working with Siddharth Shukla on sets? And what was your favorite memory of sharing the screen with him?
You know, they were all my favorite. He is a great guy to work with. He was always a lot of fun. There was never a boring moment on set, you know. Every time the director would call cut, it's like, baatein shuru ho jati thi. Meri director, main, Sid, Anik sir, sare maze karte the. So parivar sa ban gaya tha, and it was a lot of fun sharing the screen with him, you know.
Yeah. So what are your upcoming projects? If you can just get a sneak peek into it, because here already people are loving you. They are following you on Instagram immensely, and even on the YouTube videos that are out on the internet right now, everybody's like, yeah, we love Sonia Rathi and would like to know more about her, and when will she come aboard on different projects and stuff. So if you can just get a sneak peek into what are you planning on?
First of all, thank you. That was really nice. And I'm very grateful for all the love I've been getting. And in terms of other projects coming up, I am taking it one step at a time, you know. I'm seeing where the cards end up. I'm still figuring everything out, and let's see when this releases. I mean, it's only 4 days away and I'm really excited. So yeah, one step at a time and just letting cards play out.
It's said that whenever an actor engages in any kind of a project, be it a film, be it a web series, there are always certain kinds of takeaway that we take from the experience that we have with the actors and the directors. So what was your takeaway from the sets of Broken But Beautiful 3 that you will cherish for the rest of your life? Something that to remember by?
I learned so much because it was my first set, and especially as a lead, and I was learning things every day. But in terms of character, you're right. Every time you play a character, you somehow take something back with you. And in terms of Rumi, I think I did take her warriorness. Like, she's the kind of like a lioness, and she'll get what she wants no matter what happens. And I think I took that a little bit with me because I loved it about her. So I just grabbed it.
So a lot of fans actually want to dig in and know about your fitness routine. I don't know if you have observed it, but on your Instagram pictures or even on the trailer of the Broken But Beautiful, a lot of fans have commented that Sonia Rathi looks absolutely fit and fine, and we would like to dig in that what goes behind maintaining that perfect body. So if you can just give a sneak peek to our fans about what goes behind your fitness regimen. So they'll really want to know about that. They're very curious.
I wish I had a better answer, but I dance. I really need to get into a good fitness routine, which I'm working on right now. But yeah, I don't really have any perfect answer for you right now. I do a lot of things, I guess. I don't know.
So, Sonali, I will ask you that, what's your whole take about this whole OTT revolution that has come right now? In terms of the movies and web series that are now releasing on the OTT platforms, because the theaters have been now shut because of the pandemic. So what's your take upon it as an actor?
As an actor, I think OTT platforms are brilliant because they don't only give opportunities to actors, but directors, for writers, for content creators in general. And, the content that's being dished out is quite amazing, and we're seeing that with a lot of Indian shows that are making it huge in the US even, and I'm just excited to be a part of this new wave of entertainment.
So if you would like to name one web series or one show that kept you hooked during the lockdown, something that you enjoyed watching on OTT platforms, so what would that be?
I watched so many. Recently I just finished Shadow and Bone, which I actually loved. It's on Netflix. I also watched Elite. I watched a different array of things, but those two I recently watched.
Okay, so my last question would be that in your future, if you get to do a Bollywood film, then which actor would you like to romance on screen? Who's your favorite guy from the Bollywood?
Oof, that's tough. I like a lot of actors. I think their work is brilliant. If you're asking just for romance, I would say probably Ranbir Kapoor, because I think he does very well in those kinds of films. Like, even his chemistry with Deepika in Ye Jawani Hai Deewani was incredible. So I would definitely want to experience working with him one day.
Okay, I think I'm done with you. Thank you very much for your time. It was lovely talking to you. And the trailer is already rolling on the internet and fans are going crazy about this chemistry that you and Siddharth share on screen. So all the very best, and we hope that this becomes a very huge hit on the OTT. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.